Android rooting is a process to gain privilege to fully control Android operating system. Once getting root access, you can effortlessly uninstall, pre-install and system apps. Run fast, upgrade to latest Android version, install apps that require root access and much more. With so many benefits it brings, you must wonder how to root your Android phone. So hey guys, my name is Kashif and let's get started. Unlocking your Android phone's bootloader is the first step to rooting and flashing custom ROM. So there are many ways to unlock your Android phone bootloader, but I have given an article link in which I have provided you how you can easily unlock bootloader almost on any Android phone. So make sure to check it out. So let's come back at the rooting process. First of all, make a full backup of your Android phone. Nobody confirms that Android rooting is absolutely safe and lossless. To avoid any potential data loss, it's necessary to backup your Android phone before rooting your Android phone. Download and run TuneCo Android Root tool on your computer. Before connecting your Android device, you need to enable USB debugging option. Now connect your Android phone or tablet to the computer via your USB cable or Wi-Fi. Once recognized, your Android phone or tablet will show up in the primary window and it will install an app called Mobile Go on your Android phone. Make sure to give this app all the permissions on your Android phone to run the TuneCo app without any issue. So as you can see, we have successfully connected the phone via PC. Click on the toolbox, then click one click root to root your Android phone. In the rooting process, keep your Android phone being connected. You can also use this TuneCo Android Root tool to backup important files on your phone before rooting your Android. It will start the rooting process and it may reboot your Android phone. So as you can see, after reboot, the rooting process has been completed. You can eject the USB cable from the phone. Now check whether your phone is rooted or not. So as you can see, my phone has been rooted successfully. If you get failed in this process, I must say that repeat the same process again. So that's it for now. If this process doesn't work, I have given a couple of link of rooting guide, so make sure to check it out. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my content, do hit the subscribe button and I will catch you in the next one.